another journey into town today. Just gonna meet up with Ben, maybe have a bit of a laugh, we'll see what happens. He asked me at like 11 o'clock if I wanted to go meet him, like have a bit of a chill session with him or whatever. And fucking, it's 3 o'clock in the afternoon now. I've literally just made it to the edge of my estate, so I've got another like half an hour to walk. So I'm a little bit late. You see that tower? Okie dokie. Damn, I need a piss. I mean, like, the perfect place to have piss as well, but it's just a fucking field. The problem is, this track has a blind corner right there, so I can't see who's coming, and it's a guarantee that as soon as I drop my pants, someone's going to walk around that corner. I'm going to risk it, because I need a piss. I pulled it off. Look at that, I've got the whole track to myself, yay! Finish talk bullshit. There's nobody here to hear my bullshit. I'm nearly there now. Just like another sort of 5 to 10 minutes of walking. And I'm meeting him at the churchyard apparently. So I've got my bag. Here it is. It's got my juggling balls and my nunchucks in it. So I'm hoping that we're just going to have a nice little chill out sesh. Just a bit of juggling, having a laugh. We'll see. There's all sorts of people at the churchyard. Lots of people at the churchyard.
I can't swallow a whole paracetamol. I've just snapped it.
I like this spot. Take it. Here's a view that not many people get. That's not me. I wish that was me, that's not me. This is a nice view though down here, isn't it? Don't fall, you guys. Be safe.
This is about the height we was climbing up the Wesley when he was just like bouncing off in one hand.
Fucking nut job.
Some people just have no sense, do they?
No. It's a nice view of town around here though. So yeah, we're just gonna chill here for a bit, guys. You're welcome to join us if you want. I don't know.
Oh yeah?
So? I'd say nice one.
Let's have a go at these. Yeah, I'm going to end up dropping one off the edge of the car. He's not just joining at the opposite side, it's doing a window, which is that, which is a completely different trick.
Right, I am learned, yeah.
Because that's an underfront and an overfront. Whereas this has got all the different and then just that under arm.
It's the worst part about it is the sound, definitely, but it's fucking waterproof.
Is it actually?
Yeah.
Oh, that's sweet, man.
I know, it's fucking sick, isn't it?
What, I thought it would be.
No way, it's fucking way too dope.
Yeah, if it goes in my box.
Oh, right.
Nice. It may never be sweet.
Oh, David.
Sorry, man.
It's alright, that was a juggler's throw. It was not a juggler's catch.
Nah, the thing is with juggling, everyone jokes about dropping it because you don't escape it, everyone does it to learn, and everyone does it with every new trick ever. Like,
that's the thing.
It's when people get disheartened by dropping it, it's like, what the fuck's the point?
It does.
I notice when people get disheartened by anything when it's going wrong.
Yeah.
You're like, why the fuck are you getting disheartened? That's just you learning. Like, it's the only way it can happen, isn't it?
You feel like you should be doing better at that point, that's what, isn't it? I'm better than this, you know. I should already be past this stage. I've been at this stage forever.
Maybe you just need to
accept
your ability more, or
definitely.
Maybe it's just like ego things.
It can be, yeah, it is.
It's more like ego, actually.
With the pins, I should be juggling two pins. There's no way I should be picking three up, you know?
Yeah.
I should be going 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2 for days.
Yeah.
But I don't. I pick three up and I drop it, and I get well pissed off at myself after dropping it over and over and over again.
I know there's some of people skate land when they can't always something.
Yeah, I got there on the BMX eventually as well. Yeah. I was like, fucking, why is this happening for me? And everyone's like, calm down, Jonny, what the fuck? And I'm like, no, you don't understand. I really want it.
Yeah, I'm stuck.
I don't know, you're right, it does happen to everybody over things, and it probably is the ego.
Yeah, it's either the ego or something else.
I bought it for the fireflies, so... You know what I mean? I bought it around that time because that woman had a go at the shitty quality of our video. And I just happened to have a bit of money at the time, so I thought, right, fuck you then, bitch. I'll buy a better quality camera. No, I think I actually had it before that. Okay. From this distance, in that camera, it looks like I'm standing on a beach with the seaside in the background.
Oh,
yeah, check it out.
I throw an ollie on the sand and it's just like, oh man, I totally see what you mean, that looks weird.
We're just fucking at that.
That is weird, yeah.
Hello, we're not really on the beach, you guys know, because you can see.
Well, yeah, they'll be able to see it loads different ways. From here, that does just look like. That's creepy, yeah.
Let me film that shit.
Oh, kind of, I hit it.
Yeah.
Look at all the pretty lights. Such a pretty town. Oh, no, no. Camera can't deal with it. Camera can't deal with it. Stupid autofocus. Oh, Neil. Say hello, B&Q. Hello, B&Q!
You always say hello to B&Q.
Yeah.
Twice you've done that.
Yeah, that's fuck all. Can that see that board? Just out of interest from there. Because that'd be interesting, wouldn't
it? Yeah, that's so bright on there, isn't it? Has it got night vision or some shit?
No, it's not night vision. It's just the fucking... The lights are just...
That's so bright, man.
Yeah, man. That's how we look.
Alright.
So over there, yeah, that tower with the red dots on it, that I can focus, there it is, that's Grimsby Dock Tower, and because that exists, everyone was really worried in World War II that Grimsby was going to get bombed, because they were going to invade, sorry, not bombed, they were going to invade England at Grimsby, and then use that dock tower in order to signal their troops to come and invade from this angle.
I think they was never going to take down the dock tower because they used it as a
They
point
wanted
to
it.
Fly about.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. That was the reference
not exactly
to get in.
Unnoticeable,
man. So yeah, that Germany wanted that. They wanted that dock tower that I can't get focused again now. There it is. You got to zoom through it. You got to zoom through the unfocused section.
It's not functional now. It's just...
Nice. Acoustics.
It's mad, isn't it?
Yeah, man, I fucking love it.
So apparently these days at school, kids have to watch the news in tutorial group. What do you think to that? I've literally just heard it, so I haven't had time to form any thoughts on the idea. But I never used to watch shit at school. We used to nick somebody's phone and make prank calls. That's all tutor group was for us. Do you guys have to watch news?
Pint of milk, and then I grabbed all the cereal and drank the milk out of that.
Apparently your body was craving the calcium. It was like, shit man, we need to build these bones back up. You've been letting us down.
You said a small one, but I guess it's a medium. I guess it's a strong medium.
A strong medium.
Fair.
There they go, skating away. Blue and green today, it's pink and purple last time, wasn't it? No, no, the bottom one changes. The bottom one changes colour, lads. The bottom one fucking changes colour as you're walking along. That's why it confused the fuck out of me last time. So, it's pretty dark. Pretty late. Dunno, probably about 6-ish, maybe? I've got a phone, I'll check. I feel a bit weird. You know, because it's fucking, there's only dodgy people out this time of night. Yeah, it's 6:10, go figure. So yeah, that was a pretty cool day. Went down to the churchyard and met Ben, and then we went to the car park, and it was Connor's birthday, so Connor came down with his girlfriend for a bit, decided, you know, it's a bit weird filming people you don't know, and I've never met Connor's girlfriend before, and I barely know Connor, so, I mean, I didn't even really get a chance to formally introduce Ben. Just got carried away with juggling and shit like that, do you know what I mean, just having a laugh with it all. So, we were playing about and that, it got dark, and then the security guards came, dead nice guy, dead nice security guard. Just came up, he was having a laugh with us. I told him we'd get ourselves scooching, so, you know, rather than waiting for him to tell us to move on, I was just like, we'll get ourselves gone then, shall we, mate? He's like, yeah, that's probably a good idea. So, you know, we decided to make a move. We went for some food, but the food place was closed, so everybody's really hungry. So they're off home now, I'm off home. So peaceful when everything finally shuts up, innit? Oh, here comes more cars. Really loud when they're about. Brum. Brum. I wanted to make an advert for the quietest engine on the road. And obviously, that's never going to happen, so I'll give you the idea and maybe you can pitch it to them, alright? So when a car company comes up eventually with the quietest engine on the road, I want to make an advert that shows like a guy in a car, he's like proper speeding along, listening to like proper heavy metal music, you know, but all you can hear is the heavy metal music because there's no engine sounds, that's the whole point. And then there's a little girl skipping in the road, and all you hear is like shh, and it just fades to black, and you're like, quietest engine on the road. I don't know, it's just a thought. Ooh, I'm there somewhere, I'm dead dark. I've changed the camera angle so that you can see slightly more, hopefully. Ooh, spooky. Spooky. I prefer to be somewhere like this than walking down the side of a road, I tell you that for nothing. Best thing about being here is if I see a person, I know that I've got to be aware of that person, you know? It's a rarity that you'd see another human being. That's a fox, though. Oh, disappeared before you guys could see it, I think. But yeah, if you're walking down the side of the street, you know, seeing another person, it's not really much to take into consideration. And so, literally anyone at any time could, like, turn out to be a psychopath, you know? But down here, you see one person, that person's probably a psychopath. It's probably worth treating them like they're a psychopath, you know, just while you get around them. I don't mean run away, I just mean be prepared to defend yourself against the knife-wielding maniac just as you walk past this person, you know? Just for a minute. That makes sense, doesn't it? to know when to be defensive stops you being paranoid, doesn't it? Does that make sense? I'm just rambling shit again. It don't matter either way, really. I guess it kind of does. No, it don't. Nobody cares. See, I've just noticed that there's a person behind me, and that is some freaky ass shit. They're quite a way behind me, but you may have noticed I picked up the pace a little bit. You know. It's not worth hanging about, even though I know for a fact I'm perfectly safe. And it's just a normal human being. It's just the fact that, you know, it doesn't, you know, like I said, treat them all as psychopaths. That's the way to stay alive. Treat everybody like they're a psychopath.
Can you see the moon? I like when the moon does that shit.
That's awesome. It just makes like a hole in the clouds. I don't really get how that works. Because that hole's staying there. Them clouds are moving, but the hole's staying.
Obviously, it's too blurry for you guys to see properly on this camera. It's a fucking brilliant camera, but it doesn't do very much at night, you know? Pretty shitty at night. If I do get attacked, right, you just got to listen carefully to the end of this video, because what I'll do is I'll scream out details, you know, like in that Taken movie. Yeah. I'd just be like, ugh, he's wearing a hoodie. That's probably not one of them. The guy behind me probably isn't the psychopath that's going to kill me. But, you know, there's always psychopaths out there. Some of them probably want to kill me. Can't think why. Ooh. So yeah, just walking home now. It's really pretty dark though, so it's kind of hard to film this, because I know that I'm going in and out of focus, and when I watch that back it's going to drive me crazy, so, you know, I can get some views like this. I just wander along for a bit.
I can do that for you if you like. So yeah, schools these days, they watch the news in tutorial group. For anyone who's like unfamiliar with the school systems here, basically tutorial is the start period. It's kind of like registration, and back in my day that's literally all it was. It's just registration. So basically you had this one teacher who was, you know, he was the guy who was in charge of tutorial group, you know, so every group of kids had their own tutor, and this was basically the teacher who you'd come to if you had any problems, or the other teachers would go to if they had any problems with you, you know, so he was like the go-between sort of guy. And besides that, he didn't really do a great deal, or she, obviously. Mine was a male, which is why I keep saying he, all the way through, actually. I don't think I ever had a female tutor. But anyway, yeah, so Mr. Johnston's one that stands out, because I never had any kind of, like, you know, confidential conversations with him or anything, you know. I never felt like I could share information with him, or like he was supposed to be personal to me in some way. He was just a normal bloke teaching a lesson where nothing happened, you know. They just took register. And that was the important register, basically, because that happened every lesson, and as a kid, you can't tell the difference. You don't know the difference between an important one and a not important one, you know? So yeah, nowadays, in tutorial group, did it go on for me maybe 20 minutes, I think it was? And we'd just sit there and have a laugh. There was fuck all happening, you know? I remember one or two times a subject being brought up, and we'd all just sit there and chat about some bullshit. As if we were in college or something, you know? As if we were in debate club. Some shit like that. I'd always end up on the side that nobody else took, obviously. You know? What about this? What nobody's thought of? Well, nobody's thought of that, Jonny, because it's a retarded thing to say. Oh, right, okay. I still think it's important, and calling me a retard don't really help change my opinion, but thanks for that. You know, exaggerated example, but nevertheless, it's pretty much the way it always goes. How are you supposed to learn if they never tell you the truth? They just tell you this is the way you should think, you know, not the way you should think. This is what you should think. And I'm not going to tell you why or how I came to that conclusion. Alright, okay. How do I find out? Well, you've got to know what it is that you don't know that you've got to go find out. And go find it out. Alright. I don't know, and you do know, so you could just tell me. Fucking hell. Can you tell this is about more than just school at this point? It shouldn't be. I'll get back to the subject. Point is, nowadays at school... I'll start again. So nowadays at school, the teaching, in tutor group, the kids are watching the news, like the morning news. And that's, you know, because back in my day it was just a registration group, basically. I can't remember anything important ever being discussed in tutor group. It's just a good time for a teacher to take you aside and say, you know, this other teacher's been telling me that you're shit at maths or English or whatever. You know, it was on a personal level. The tutor was just like the go-between between the other teachers and you as a student. I think. But nowadays, they're watching the news. So, obviously, anybody who's watching YouTube probably doesn't trust the news, right? I mean, if you're spending enough time on YouTube... if you're spending literally any time on YouTube at all, you're coming across the idea that the news is absolutely corrupt. I suppose there's some people who just ignore that kind of shit flat out. Like, I don't give a fuck if it's corrupt or not. I'll watch it anyway, and I'm not watching your shitty 20-minute video about it. Do you know what I mean? But really, we all know that the news is corrupt. Yeah? I mean, nobody cares. It's not like it's a big secret or anything. Everybody knows that the news is fucking everybody up the arse. It's an entertainment show. We stopped giving a fuck what the news cared about when it became readily apparent that they didn't give a fuck what they were telling us about. You know, I can't put my finger on an exact moment, but there was kind of a flip in the media where it was like, and now we're going to make it obvious that we're telling you what to think about. Do you know what I mean? And I think at that point, everybody stopped... Once they stopped taking it seriously, we stopped taking it seriously. It's like, well, you know, they're sat there like, look, the game's up. You know what we're doing. We know that you know what we're doing. Why don't we just fucking display it for everybody to see? And I think everybody thought, well, that's not the game, you know? You've got to put some effort in. So if you're not going to put the effort in, we're not going to put the effort in. I'm pretty sure that's how most people feel about the news, isn't it? I mean, it's shit. Everybody knows it's utter garbage. The last thing I saw, because I've got a subscription to, like, Channel 4 and BBC News on Facebook. This is because I don't have a TV, you see, so... Every now and then I see little segments. Usually I just see the title and I think, I'm not watching that, it's bullshit. But I saw a segment about Trump, because, you know, I was interested. And they just had this guy crying about nothing. This guy was on Channel 4, standing in front of Jon Snow. The only reason I remember his name is because he's got white hair. Is there anybody else who only remembers Jon Snow's name because he's got white hair? Is that racist? I don't even know anymore. But anyway, Jon Snow was interviewing this guy who was just crying about nothing at all. And I thought, what is it? It's entertainment. All it is, it's just drama at this point. It's for lazy people. So lately there's been this whole big hoo-ha about fake news. And the only reason the media are even recognising the fake news suddenly is because the fake news, quote-unquote, got it 100% right. from the beginning to the end, they called it as they saw it, and they got it 100% right. They weren't hiding anything from anyone. Whereas the real media were not giving a fuck anymore. We're talking about in America, right? Over the whole Hillary and Trump thing. I mean, here in England, we've got our own version of it, but it's not as extreme. And it is the whole Hillary and Trump debate that showed the media for what it really is capable of being. Just completely 100% wrong. So like I say, over here it's bad enough. I mean, it's a joke, isn't it? The media worldwide is a fucking joke. But the BBC have got a little bit more class still, even though it's not very much, they've got a little bit more class than CNN, you know? So, it was, oh my God, cringeworthy watching the whole debate process happen and, you know, seeing the American news sources and what they were saying and then going and actually looking up the facts for myself. I mean, there was a point where I actually supported Trump just because I knew that the bullshit that they were saying about him was completely inaccurate and I didn't know anything about the real guy. Like, every time I went and checked something out, some horrible story about him, it turned out to be fuck all. Compared to Hillary Clinton, it was fuck all. But I didn't know anything about his actual policies. So I didn't know the horrible things that he was actually planning on doing, you know? And now that's readily apparent. Nobody told me, and it's too late. Good job I didn't vote, innit? I don't vote, you see. I don't vote. I don't vote, you see. I never have, and I don't ever intend to. I don't think there's a single vote that I understand, like, enough to make a decision, you know? I think it's really selfish of people to cast a vote when they're completely blind and ignorant to a subject. Like, let's take this veganism thing as a perfect example of that, right? Okay, I'm against veganism, and I'm willing to accept that I don't know anything about it. I'm just an average, everyday guy eating meat. Right? So if there was like a vote in Parliament on whether we should or should not be allowed to eat meat anymore, you know, I wouldn't vote. I wouldn't go out to a polling booth and say, yes, we should be able to eat meat, because I don't know fuck all about it. I've got no information whatsoever. So it's up to you guys, you know what I mean? I'm not bothered. I'm just trying to live my life. In amongst all these bullshit rules, just kind of trying to meander through them, you know? It's not as easy as it looks sometimes. Hence the reason I got kicked out of a parking lot by a security guard parking lot. Car park. Easy. Recording vlogs when there's people about, man. It's weird. That was fucking weird, right? So, this guy, he's just like creeping along on a bike a little bit behind me, and I didn't know if he was just riding slow or if he was following me or what, and I suddenly realised that he'd been there while I'd been chatting bullshit, which is obviously embarrassing anyway, do you know what I mean? For anyone, I'm a human being, I get embarrassed sometimes. A lot of the time. I don't know why I do this. Anyway, he comes over and he's like, you're vlogging? I was like, yeah, man. And he stuck his thumb up and it turns out he's a vlogger as well. So, that's weird. Two in this town, that's annoying. I thought I was the only one. I'm the only gay in the village. Except I can't do that because I never watched Little Britain. But yeah, kind of like that, you know? Tastes a little bit like... No, it's good, man. It's nice to meet people who are into the same things. Especially YouTube. It's one of them, like... I don't know, it's a strange little art form, isn't it, YouTube? It's a strange little world. So, having someone in real life that knows what you're doing sort of appreciates it. It's pretty cool, man. So let's face it, most people don't have a fuck about making YouTube videos. Do they really? This is really good light. I should stand on a roundabout and record my videos. So yeah, I totally lost my train of thought. Something about news media bad. Oh yeah, the kids. I never got to my whole point, did I? So yeah, we all understand that as adults, that the news is bullshit and it's just an entertainment program that should not, under any circumstances, be taken even the least bit seriously. Obviously, we're all aware of that, yeah? We're on the same page. But the kids know that because, you know, it's the kind of fucked up program that really should have a 9 o'clock watershed, isn't it? It can put some bizarre ideas into people's heads. You know, if they started taking that shit seriously. You remember, like, they were blaming books a while back, like certain books for kids being real, like, you know, temper tantrum motherfuckers. Bit of light on my face. Well, I can see that happening again if we're letting the motherfuckers watch the news. Because this is 10 times more barbaric than any of them books were. Anyway, I've come the shop way, because I can't help myself. I'm going to have to buy something. Some kind of little goodie. I feel like I've earned it. So, this is where our journey ends. Take it easy. Nice to see you. Have fun. Bye.